Good morning students, welcome to our National Public School online sessions. So dear students, in the last session we were dealing about the microorganisms, friends and foe. So under that we were studying about the beneficial aspects of microbes, because already now we are aware that microorganisms not only they are harmful, they are beneficial also. So one of the very good important aspect, beneficial aspect of microorganism, in the last session we have come to know that yeast cells, they are used exclusively in the bakery in order to leaven the dough, that is in the leavening of the dough. Now let us study about the preparation of the antibiotics. So this antibiotics means the any preparation that is prepared from the extracts from the microorganism that will be having the ability to kill a class of bacteria, that is known as the antibiotic. Anti means here against, bio means here life forms. So these antibiotics, they are having the capability to kill a wide range of bacteria, hence it is known as the antibiotic. Actually it is the natural extracts or the preparation, secondary metabolites that are produced by the a set of microorganisms, especially the bacteria. So good example is streptomycin, then chloramphenicol, then gentamicin, tetracycline. So all these are the antibiotics that are extensively produced by the bacteria. So you might have seen another one wonder drug, that is the penicillin. So this penicillin, it is produced by a set of mold. So that molds are produced in the secondary metabolite, and it has got a wide range to kill the many of the most of the bacteria. Hence penicillin, it is also an antibiotic and it is also called as the wonder drug. Next is the vaccine preparation. So dear students, you might have observed, whenever any microorganism enters our body through any route, that is through inhalation or ingestion or any insect bites or somewhat like that. So that microorganism, when it enters our body recognizes that organism as the foreign, and in order to fight, that is the immunity, the natural immunity what we have got, as a result of that immunity, our body or our system produces some proteins. So that proteins are also called as antibodies. So antibodies means these are the special proteins that are produced by WBC cells, that is the white blood corpuscles, and they are basically proteinaceous in nature. So these antibodies, they have got the capability to kill the invading microbe, thus protecting our body against the infection. So thus it protects our body from getting infected and protects from the diseases. Hence antibodies are the nothing but the natural proteins that are produced in our body against the introduction or administration of the antigen. So here antigen is nothing but the microbe. So in order to give artificial immunity, because right from the newborn baby up to 5 years of age, the children will be not having defense mechanism or immunity, because till the immunity it will be in the developing stage. So in order to protect the children from getting infection, artificial immunity will be given through the vaccines. So you might have heard about many vaccines for small children they give, and also you may ask your parents, when you were small children, what are the vaccines that had got administered, that they had administered you also. So their vaccines are nothing but they are the purely microbial preparation, and in this vaccine either the live organisms will be used or inactivated microorganisms will be used in the preparation. That is, either organism will be in the live condition, that is in the living cells, and also either it may be living organism or inactivated. Inactivated means the organism will be dead, but it will be having the capacity to produce the antibodies. So these vaccines, either it will be given orally or it may be through the help of injections, that is in the form of injection. So whenever they will give the vaccine, so good example is polio. So you are all familiar with the vaccine, polio vaccine. So this polio vaccine also, it is administered in two ways. One is oral route, another is through the injection route, that is will be inactivated, and such inactivated toxin is called as the toxoid. So such preparations will be taken and it will be administered for the small children, that is the children below 5 years of age. So when this antigen, that is the vaccine, it is administered, the immune system it recognizes and accordingly it will produce the antibodies. So once it produces the antibody, the memory cells will be having the memory, so that whenever the wild type of organism enters, again it will produce the corresponding type of antibodies, thus protecting the system from getting the infections and the diseases. So nowadays we are seeing how much worldwide campaign they are giving for polio eradication. So because of which they are giving free schedules time to time. They are giving the free schedules of the polio vaccine just in order to make the whole world free from polio virus. Because once the children are affected by the polio virus, the children will become crippled for life. There is no treatment. So once, because the main organ that will get affected will be the nervous system, especially the limbs. So once if they are crippled, they are crippled for their whole lifetime. So one such report is also the whole world when there was pandemic about the smallpox. They gave so much publicity and also so much campaigns in order to eradicate smallpox, and it was only effectively eradicated only through the vaccination. So the first disease to be completely eradicated from the entire world was smallpox, and now the next target they are giving for the polio. So now you might have observed, you have understood how much a beneficial aspect we are getting from the organism. So that organism only it is causing the infection, but that organism, if you are using in a suitable manner, that is either in the inactivated condition or its toxoid form, we can eradicate the particular disease completely. So this is about the vaccines. So apart from this polio vaccine, smallpox vaccine and all, there are other vaccines, BCG. You might have observed on your hands, on the upper arm, you might have seen that BCG vaccine will be given. So that BCG vaccine, it is given for tuberculosis. So BCG stands for Bacillus Calmette Guerin. Like that typhoid also, there is one vaccine called as a TAB vaccine, T-A-B, TAB vaccine. So like that different vaccines are available, so that if it is given in the initial condition for the children below 5 years of age, we can boost up the immunity, and since here it is given artificially, it is known as artificial immunity. Next is the increasing the soil fertility. As you have known, in many classes we have discussed that the nitrogen, it is present abundantly in the atmosphere, and the plants badly require this nitrogen for their normal physiological function. But the plants do not directly absorb the free nitrogen. It has to get converted into the usable form. So that the conversion, it is brought about by the bacteria or the microorganism. Otherwise, artificially they will spray the organism into the fields, that is Azolla, Azospirillum, Rhizobacter, Rhizomium. So these bacteria, they will capture that free atmospheric nitrogen and they will dissolve and convert into the usable form, and this usable form will be easily can be absorbed by the plants. So the microbes, they are involved in order to increase the soil fertility. If the soil fertility is good, then definitely we can expect the good harvesting. The last is the cleaning the environment. You might see in your neighborhood, if the plant or animal it is dead, lying dead, it will not remain there only. Within few days or few hours, the whole organism will get consumed. Where the, actually that plant and animal has gone, nothing but these microorganisms, they will decompose. the dead bodies of plants and animals. So actually thanks for the organism because they are helping to clean the environment. So in order to correlate this one small activity here I will explain. Just you can do it in your home also and find the difference. So in one pot you take only the organic matter. So suppose here in one pot you take all the organic matter, that is the fruit peels or vegetable peels or any matter waste materials you can take. In another pot you put all inorganic material, that is the polythene covers, plastic bottles or any rubber items, all these things you take in this one and then sprinkle with water and cover and leave it for one few days, 1 week or so you leave it. So after 5-6 days if you see you can note down that difference. So in the pot A in which we have taken organic materials such as the animal, that is animal waste or cow dung or fruit peels, vegetable waste and all, in this one the whole matter will undergo decomposition because it is an organic material and definitely the bacteria can bring about the decomposition. It will convert the complex materials into simple substances. Whereas in case of pot B, in which we have taken all inorganic, that is the plastic, rubber items or papers like that, or plastic and rubber items, it will never undergo decomposition because this is mainly because microbes, it cannot bring about decomposition of inorganic material. The same thing we can see in our environment also. You might have seen how much polythene covers or plastic bottles, it will be lying there only months together, years together, but it will never undergo rottening. Whereas any organic material, if it is lying within hours or within few days, it will get consumed. So this shows that microbes, it will help to clean the environment. So these are the important beneficial aspects of microorganism in our daily life and to what extent they are helpful. So one already has studied the leavening of the bread, that is extensively used in the bakeries. Then preparation of antibiotics, life-saving drugs are prepared from the microbes. Then vaccine preparation, increasing the soil fertility, then cleaning the environment. So dear students, hope you have understood the important aspects of microorganism. And in the next session, we shall study about what is the other side of the coin, that is the harmful effects of the microbes. So thank you children, have a good day.